हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ साजन बाबू डुंगाना, फोर्थ ईयर MBBS स्टूडेंट एट BPKSS। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन द टॉपिक कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन थेरेपी। आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू नो अबाउट द एक्यूट एंड क्रोनिक कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन थेरेपी एंड टू नो अबाउट द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द ऑक्सीजन टॉक्सिसिटी इन द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन टॉक्सिसिटी। टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑक्सीजन टॉक्सिसिटी, इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, एक्यूट टॉक्सिसिटी एंड क्रोनिक टॉक्सिसिटी। Acute toxicity is also known as Paul Watt effect, and in this CNS symptoms are common, and high concentration of oxygen are used for the short duration. And in chronic toxicity, also known as Loren-Smith effect, pulmonary symptoms are common and lower concentration of gas are used for the longer duration. What are the factors affecting the toxicity? First one is patient susceptibility. For example, in G6PD deficient patient, the chance of toxicity is more. In the next one is fraction of the oxygen on the expired year. For example, 60% of FiO2 takes more than 48 hours, whereas 100% takes more than 12 hours only. And with the pressure, increase in pressure of the oxygen therapy, there is more toxicity. And also same happens with the duration of the therapy. Mechanism of toxicity. Oxygen produces the free radicals such as superoxide, oxygen singlet, and hydroxyl radical, and also H2O2 called hydrogen peroxide. These free radicals causes lipid peroxidation of the cell membrane and inhibits the nucleic acid and protein synthesis, and also inactivates the cellular enzymes. Pulmonary toxicity. Lung is the first organ to show the changes due to oxygen toxicity, and the toxicity is due to alveolar concentration rather than the arterial concentration. And with 100% normobaric oxygen, symptoms of the pulmonary toxicity appear after about 12 hours. And in neonates, it present as the bronchopulmonary dysplasia. The mechanism is similar. The intercellular generation of highly reactive oxygen free radicals such as superoxide, activated hydroxyl ions, and the hydrogen peroxides. And this oxidation of the SH group of the essential enzymes such as coenzyme A and the peroxidation of the lipid causes the inhibition of the cell function. And it leads to the conditions like tracheobronchitis, acute respiratory distress syndrome, and the pulmonary fibrosis. In general, 3 to 6 hours of exposure of 2 atmospheric oxygen causes mild irritation, whereas after the 10 hours, intense irritation with an uncontrolled coughing and finally the chest pain, dyspnea, and the impairment of the pulmonary function can develop. Another important manifestation is the atelectasis, and it is an absorption atelectasis. It is due to the replacement of the nitrogen in the alveoli by the oxygen, causing the greater uptake of the oxygen, which leads to the alveolar collapse. So it is also known as absorption atelectasis, and it occurs in 6 minutes with 100% oxygen and in 60 minutes with 85% oxygen. However, if the antioxidant stores in the lungs are depleted, such as in case of ICU patient, the oxygen toxicity develops faster. So the best practice is to reduce the FiO2 to the lowest tolerable level in all ICU patient. Another important manifestation of the oxygen toxicity is the CNS toxicity, and it commonly occurs at the high oxygen pressure. However, it may also occur at lower pressure if exposure is prolonged, and it is mainly due to the oxidation and polymerization of the SH group of enzymes, leading to their inactivation, which in turn results in the cellular damage. And early manifestations are variable. Twitching of the perioral and the small muscles of the hand are fairly constant feature, and other symptoms include the facial numbness, twitching, nausea, unpleasant olfactory and gustatory sensations, and the acoustic symptoms. Next important manifestation is ocular, and it is due to the oxidative damage to the lens protein. In acute condition, narrowing of the visual fields occur, and in chronic condition, there is changes in the refractive index of lens, resulting in the myopia and the nuclear cataract. Another important manifestation is the retrolateral fibroplasia, which commonly are seen in the premature babies in which oxygen therapy is given. And The cause is almost always the related to the administration of high concentration of oxygen above 40% for a prolonged period of 1 to 2 days following birth. In premature infants of less than 30 weeks of the gestation or less than 1500 grams of the birth weight appear to be at great risk, and this process is reversible. So it is not a sole criteria to restrict the use of oxygen therapy. Another important manifestation is the cardiovascular, in which the increase in PO2 of the blood leads to the vasoconstriction of the peripheral vessels and also in the cerebral, coronary, hepatic and renal circulation. The mechanism is that there are the endothelium in the blood vessels. There are the endothelial cells in the blood vessels which produce vasodilators known as the endothelium derived nitric oxide. In the high concentration of oxygen causes the decreased production of this vasodilator, leading to the vasoconstriction. And another effect are the negative ionotropic effect, and there is also the absence of the hypoxemic drive for the cardiac stimulation, and there is direct myocardial depletion. Another important topic to discuss is the hyperbaric oxygen toxicity. It is due to the oxygen therapy at higher pressure, greater than 1 atmospheric pressure, which we usually breathe. And the pulmonary manifestation are acute respiratory distress syndrome. In CNS, there are seizures, which are preceded by the facial numbness, twitching, unpleasant olfactory and gustatory sensations. In eye, there is myopia, nuclear cataract, and retrolental fibroplasia, most commonly in the neonates. And another important manifestation is the avascular necrosis of the bones, and there is also barotrauma. Avascular necrosis is due to the vasoconstriction in the bone tissue due to the interruption of the blood flow, which causes the avascular necrosis of the bone segment. And how can we prevent it? The principle of the safe oxygen therapy are to use the low concentration of the oxygen for short duration of time, and also the effective and proper use of oxygen delivery devices also helps to prevent the oxygen toxicity. In summary, we can see that the chemical toxicity leading to the tracheobronchial tree damage, alveolar epithelial damage, capillary epithelial damage, leading to pulmonary damage and atelectasis, which may cause hypoxemia, acidosis and death. Also, retinal damage can occur. Also, the high oxygen pressure, the highly inspired oxygen pressure causes erythrocyte to get hemolysis. Also, the myocardial damage, endocrine effects like adrenal damage to the adrenal glands, gonads and the thyroids. There is also the chemical toxicity which can destruct any of the cell present, leading to death. Also, there are hepatic effects and renal damage. Also, there is the toxic effect on the enzymes and the cell of central nervous system, which causes twitching, convulsions and destruction of the neurons. These are my references. And I have a question for you. Which radical of oxygen is the most reactive molecule? The answer will be given in the comment section. Thank you.